Alarm goes off, band a quarter to five. Roll out of bed, rub the sleep from my eyes. Throw on a shirt and some jeans.
Hi, welcome to Tanky's Playtime. This is my new channel. And what we're going to be doing on this channel is basically Tinker Time. We all like Tinker Time. So we're going to do some different builds. So this first season of videos, we've got a bit of a major project on. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a tractor build. So what I've been doing for the past, I don't know, quite a fair few years, I've been restoring an old tractor and all that. Problem is, got a cracked engine block, didn't realise, bit of water in the oil, so we need to get around that. And I'd be honest with you, I don't like to keep things original, and I do like to tinker, so we're going to do a little bit of a play with it. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy. I'm going to enjoy doing this. It's my first time doing this as a video, so let's see how it goes. Like and subscribe if you like the videos, and hopefully it'll keep me going. So, on we go with our first project, the tractor build. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, what we got here is my 1956 Fordson Major. But fortunately, we have a cracked engine block. It runs sweet, it drives lovely, but yeah, we get a little bit of water in the wheel, and I mean, I could leave it alone and just go do the rallies with it and whatnot and just change the oil every bloody time, but yeah, nah, that don't sound like much fun to me. So what we're going to do is we're going to bang an air cooled in there. We're not going to have problems with water again, getting it all, because they're air cooled. So I spent the past 7 years doing this one up, on and off, just doing bits here, there, a few hours here, a few hours there. And it's not bad, you know, it's not what I call class A restore, but considering what it was when I first had it, yeah, it's a bit different kettle fish, but we're going to make it better, I feel. So what we got here in a beautiful corner of sunshine, and it is beautiful, I will say, is some new additions. I wanted to do something that no one else has done, so I think I found just the engine. So we have a Lister 6-pot diesel to put in. And if anyone knows me, obviously I'll put a little thing up on Instagram showing what we're going to do. And we're going to see if we can, we're going to do, will it start video to start with. See if we can get this old girl running. To see if she is an old girl. As far as I'm aware, it's come out of a clay pit. I mean, there's a drive gearbox I've took off. But yeah, as far as I'm concerned, it's come out of clay pits as a water pump basically. This was a turbo one. Although it does turbo, does need, probably need refurbing. And I actually bought two. I bought two engines. This one is basically spares. I mean, we were missing the cooling fan. But I thought, no one's done a Lister a Lister air-cooled engine in a tractor. I was looking at the Rolls-Royce option. Going to be a bit too big. Looked at a couple engines, and I didn't want to just do the whole boring Ford cargo lump. It's, I'm not saying they're boring, but everyone's doing them. Everyone's doing this Hurricanes V8s. Everyone's, you know, but I want to do something different. So, this is what we're with.
Now I go cleaning windows, earn an honest bob. For a nosy parker, it's an interesting job. Now it's a job that just suits me. A window cleaner you would be if you can see what I can see when I'm cleaning windows.
So there you have it. That's the intro into what we're going to do. We're going to do a will it start video to start with, see if we can get one of these engines up and running. At least then I know it's ready to go in. And then we'll do the video on the adaption plate, and I'll work it through as well, everything I do, because it will help future people. I mean, what I want to do is basically inspire people to do things like this, you know, to be brave and, you know, create their ideal machine, like, you know. There's a lot of people who are very handy, they just don't realise it yet. But if I can show you, actually, don't be afraid of it, let's get on with it. And we'll go from there. So we'll start with getting this engine in the workshop and see if we can get the thing started. So, right, remember to like and subscribe. See you in a moment.
me show my for pity.
So I'm looking around this engine, now I've got it in the workshop, and do you know what, it already looks better for a bloody wash. So I'm looking around it, obviously there's stuff I don't need on it for this tractor build. I mean, there's an electronic pump stop, I'm going to be taking that off because I want to do that cable. There's a sort of a thermostar on it, I'm not going to do that, we don't get cold enough over here. The turbo is seized, we did know about. I'm hoping it's just because it's been sat for so long that I can just take the top pipe off, just maybe drip feed it some oil, maybe just tease it back to life again. Alternator is also seized, so we'll be taking him off as well. And I'll be honest, the bracket that's holding it isn't much cock anyway, because it is starting to, well, as I turn the, clear the picture up, I don't know if you can see it on camera, but it's actually on an angle. It's the bracket's rotted away and the belts are pulling tight and it's suspending it. So alternator needs to come off. That thermostat capsule, that capsule there, we've got a blanker in the other engine. Turbo, we're going to drip feed some oil into it and hopefully we just get some little life in it. Pump, we've got a pump stop here, which don't need that. We got a pipe here we can chuck in a can of diesel, and hopefully might need to just refurb that pump a little bit, but the good thing is they're quite easy to repair. In fact, it looks nearly like exact same one that's on major, so I could pinch that one. And what we'll do is we'll put a bit of pipe on the end of that and we'll put that as a leak off back into the can, because that's part of the leak off system. It's either that or we blank it off and it can just leak back into the filter. We probably might we'll put on the tractor itself, we'll put that back into the tank on the tractor. Apart from that, I mean, everything else is looking okay. We'll get this cowling off. I do have another spare cowling off the other engine. I know I didn't see in the picture, but I do have one which we can change. So there is some bits as well we're going to swap off that engine. But everything else, the engine turns itself, the fan unit it will move, the engine will turn, and I say we obviously got some, well, now we've washed it off, we can see how bad the air ducts are and all the tin work. So, but the other engine, they're good. So, and we'll also take this off. I think it's something to do with a rev counter. Let me know if I'm wrong. I'm not going to use it. Well, I might do. I don't know. I need to speak to some people who are clever with electrics and maybe see if we can wire it up and make it work for the tractor. So, we'll set the camera up again and we'll off we go.
Ain't no love in the heart of time. So strange without you there, things have changed. When nighttime comes, there's a blanket of gloom, another teardrop falls in my lonely room. I said I ain't no love in the heart of the city.
So what I've done is I've changed a little bit. So we have basically, because we're 24 volt, we have, do a camera like that, we've set up a set of batteries. It's a bit wiry, I know, I've had to use set jump leads, I didn't have enough battery leads to make up to be able to do this. So, but what we're gonna do, because I don't think there's much life in those batteries, there's a bit of spark, but that's about it. So I'm just gonna on charge for a half hour, so I think we'll make myself a cup of tea. What do we reckon tonight? It must be a cup of tea time. So while I'm waiting for the batteries, also I will just make one handy note. It's handy if you're charging batteries, actually plug it in. But anyway, that's another story. What I've done is I've bled the system. So what I have is, if I get the camera to look a bit better, no, it's there, wait, right. As you see, a lot of diesel here. I've got my pipe that goes into a little bucket of diesel. Comes up here, got my finger pump. Bled it to there. I've had to blank that off just for a minute because it just kept shooting out there. And then from there, I've bled it into this one. And then I've bled it to, well, I say I bled it this one. This one's been a bit awkward, but I've got diesel there. And then what I've done is I've cracked all of these off. So when we're actually ready to try and start, we should hopefully get some diesel life. If we get some diesel life, it's got every chance of going. So it all depends now on the starter motor. So how many attempts do you think I'm going to try today before it starts? Make a guess. Put it in the comments. I'll speak to you in a minute. That's it. Right. Oh, there it goes. It's working.
All right, 24 volts?
Yeah, let's go for a bit. 24 volt. You ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready for this, kids?
Wait for the spark to fly.
Well, that's better noise. Try it the other way. That's the most that's been turning. Beautiful.
What did you get for
that?
Hmm? What did you get?
400 quid. Yeah. No, that's 100 quid for fair. 500 quid for this one. Yeah.
Oh well. It's halfway there, isn't it?
Well, it starts, it's not worth every penny, isn't it? See if we get. So. Actually. Be a couple dings in that. So this thing lives. It's great. Now I've calmed down and got a bit less excited. Yeah, I don't know what come over me though. I suppose it's just a joy of knowing we're on the right steps. So we are, there's some down points. Obviously we've got oil coming out of quite a few places. One on the turbo pipe from the filter housing, it's just rotted out, and we've got one on the front pipe as well, which is rotted out as well. As well as a hole in the sump. But again, still nothing terrible, nothing, you know, it's sounding absolutely lovely, turbo spooling up lovely as well. So, yeah, I think we're on to a win here. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, like and subscribe. Hopefully you might see some more of me then. What we'll do on part two is we will make the adaption plate up. We'll go through that step by step, how we're going to do it. I've got it in my head how I'm going to do it, but let's hope it works. If it don't, then you'll be the first ones to find out if it don't. So, yeah, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you for part two.
Alarm goes off at 4:45. Roll out of bed, rub the sleep from my eyes. Throw on a shirt and some jeans.